Hi, my name's Brad Ladewig. I work in the Barra Centre in the Department of Chemical Engineering at Imperial College London, and I'm going to talk about some of the really exciting research that we're working on. We have a particular focus on trying to solve some of the grand challenges facing the world today. Challenges around water, for example, how do we provide clean drinking water to the more than 1 billion people who don't have access to safe drinking water today? Challenges around energy. How do we transition to a clean energy future? How do we make the most of the fossil fuel resources we have today in a carbon constrained future? How do we help companies today that are oil and gas companies to transition to a future where they are renewable energy companies? These are really enormous challenges, challenges that impact on the lives of billions of people today and in the future, and things that really motivate us to work hard at our research to try and make a difference, to have impact. One of the ways that we're trying to do that is through developing advanced materials that can be used for separations. In particular, we're looking at membrane separations. One project that we're working on at the moment is trying to understand from a very fundamental perspective how gas molecules transport through membranes. This is an area that has been researched for many, many years, but there are still a lot of unanswered questions. Now we are taking advantage of some of the latest developments that allow us to prepare and manipulate materials at a scale that's never been possible before to build model systems through which we can make, for the first time, direct experimental measurements of gas transport through very well-defined systems. Another way that we're trying to develop technologies that can be used to do separations that haven't been possible before is by producing responsive membranes. Membranes that change their transport characteristics depending on whether they are illuminated or not, or exposed to some other form of external energy input. This is an incredibly exciting area of research, and one reason that makes it so exciting for us is that not all of the tools are available to do this kind of research. And in fact, we've designed and built our own membrane permeation device just so that we can make the measurements that we need to make to do this research. And that's been a lot of fun. We have even more research underway trying to separate very difficult to separate molecules. These are chiral molecules, which are extremely relevant in the pharmaceutical industry and the fine chemical sector, and for which current separation approaches are quite expensive and not that easy to scale up. And we, in our group, are using some of the latest developments in porous materials, and in particular metal organic frameworks with chiral pores or chiral recognition sites, to make adsorbents and membranes that are capable of separating chiral molecules. Finally, the last project that I'd like to talk about is relating to ion exchange membranes. And so we have a particular interest in looking for technologies that can exploit ion exchange membranes to create energy, to create valuable chemical feedstocks, but at the same time, treat waste streams. So an example of these are microbial fuel cells or bioelectrochemical systems, which to date have been really held back from commercial adoption by the lack of availability of suitable membranes. So we are working very hard to make membranes that could be produced in very large quantities, many square meters, at low cost, and exploited in some of these very innovative technologies. We are a team that is comprised of people from all around the world, and this is one of the things that makes it so interesting to come to work here each day, is that we are such a diverse group of people. We love working together, we learn from each other, and as a result, we progress, we make steps forward in tackling these great research challenges.